Here we have a 50-inch Panasonic plasma TV, model number TC-P50X5. In this video, we are going to go over what symptoms can possibly be caused by a bad power supply board and how to replace that board in this Panasonic plasma TV. Most Panasonic plasma TVs have the X-sustain board and the power supply board separate. But on this TV, they have added the X-sustain onto the power supply board. There are also other model numbers that have the X-sustain and the power supply board combined onto one. This board is located here on the panel. Some common symptoms that could be caused by a bad power supply board are if your TV has no standby and will not power up. Other symptoms can include if your TV has backlights, has sound, but does not have a picture on the screen. One other symptom that could be caused by this board being bad is if you have a distorted image on the screen. For all of these symptoms, it is recommended to start your repair by replacing the power supply board for TVs that use the following part numbers on the power supply: N0AE6JK00005 and N0AE6JK00006. Be sure to take all proper safety precautions, including unplugging your TV before doing any work. I will begin by disconnecting all of the cables and ribbons from the board. I squeeze on the connection and then firmly pull it away from the board. Be sure to use caution when disconnecting any cables. These last two ribbons are very fragile. We will show a video from a different board that shows how to properly remove the ribbons. For these two ribbon cables, there are two plastic pieces on the inside of these connections that hold the ribbon in place. You will see them highlighted here in the image. The plastic pieces push down through the holes in the ribbon to hold it secure in place. To begin removing these ribbons, I will pinch in on the side of the connection and pull it out just a little bit from the board. Do this very gently. Next, I will apply pressure to the ribbon pushing downward so that I can release it from those plastic pieces inside the connection that are holding it secure. If you feel any resistance, it may be caught and you need to put more pressure pushing downward in order to release it from those plastic pieces. Next, I will remove all of the screws that secure the board to the panel and then remove the board. Your board could still be holding a charge in it, and as a safety precaution, you should lift it off of the panel by holding the aluminum heat sinks that are highlighted on the screen. Now I can put my replacement board onto the panel and secure it in place using the screws. Next, I will reattach all of the cables and ribbons to the board. Here again is a video from a different board showing how to reconnect the ribbons. When reinstalling the ribbon, I will want to again apply pressure downward to push it below the two plastic pieces on the inside of the connection. I will apply pressure downward and then push the ribbon in. Once the ribbon is in, I will then pinch the sides again and push it back towards the board to lock it in place. We have successfully replaced the power supply board for this Panasonic TV repair. Thank you for watching one of our many tutorials here at ShopJimmy.com. If you have any further questions regarding your repair, simply post a question in the comment section below. We strive to learn and share new TV repair tips every day. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and grow with us. Share our videos with your friends to help us spread the savings. And don't forget to hit that like button.